Somebody on That Guy with the Glasses commented that Bridget is becoming like the third host on the bit, so I should probably talk about her less. I think it's starting to bother people. Hi.
There she is. Well, it's the internet.
She shall show up.
It's the internet.
She's going to come play with my headphone cords.
You can't have a show without a cat.
It's like the rules. They were actually going to take us off the air if we didn't get a cat.
We had to get a cat, yeah. So
luckily, there's a kitten now and we can stay on the air.
So are we ready for the nonsense this week?
Let's do the nonsense.
All right. Let's see here. Each week, Catherine goes out and worldwide interwebs, finds all sorts of horrible stuff, brings it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck is Wrong with You? And our first story this week, crazy. I give this guy credit for originality, but I don't think this is one of the, you really didn't think this one through. I don't think this was really thought through here. Let me send this on to you. Potato wielding man tried to rob store dry cleaners. This comes from Providence, Rhode Island. Providence police say a man carrying a potato disguised as a gun unsuccessfully attempted to rob a convenience store with dry cleaners. First report came around 2 p.m. when police reported a Branch Avenue convenience store where the store's manager said he chased the suspect off with a baseball bat after he shouted, "Give me the money." The suspect was described as a white or light-skinned Hispanic male, about 5'7". Wearing a black hooded sweatshirt and blue jeans. Minutes later, police reported to a Charles Street dry cleaners where a female clerk said a man fitting the same description and carrying a potato yelled, "I need the money." Now, this is the glorious part. The clerk handed him a counterfeit $20 bill from a decoy cash register before he walked off. So he came in with a fake gun and she gave him fake money.
Sounds fair. Everybody wanted cops and robbers that day.
You saw Bridget there. It's like, "You're doing shit. What are you doing?"
It's like, "Hey, what's going on?" Okay, I'm Irish. We can do a lot of things with a potato. Don't know how you disguise one as a gun.
There's that old...
I know that one.
There's that old, you know, prison breakout legend about how you carve a gun out of a potato. And you paint it with shoe polish to look like a gun. And supposedly you can get your way out of prison that way.
That would have to be a really big fucking potato.
That'd have to be a big fucking potato.
Like, you're talking a turnip at that point.
Yeah, and people are in the channel going, "Potato gun, you're doing it wrong."
Yeah, like, I know about guns that shoot potatoes.
Not a gun that is a potato.
Yeah.
You know, I would think he, at this point, he would have been much better off just eating the potato.
They are a superfood.
And I love how no one fell for the shit is the beautiful thing.
I love how they have a decoy register with fake money in case they get robbed.
Just in case someone comes in with a fake gun.
I feel like that should be the new standard in retail. Like, you should just keep a fake register full of fake money.
It's the irony register.
Yeah.
If you come in with a fake gun, you get fake money.
Hell, if you come in with a real gun, you get fake money. Fuck you. I think if I own a retail establishment, that's going to be how I roll.
You know, he tried something new, at least. Of course, I'm going to have to call shame on Dan McGowan, WPRI reporter. Why? Because the first line of the story is, "Talk about a half-baked crime! Woohoo!" Don't ever. That's just.
I hit that button. That's like my favorite button.
Not that. Just the whole. This guy went.
I thought you were upset at my rim shot button, and I'm like, "That's my favorite button."
This guy, in theory, went to journalism school for that.
I went to journalism school.
And you don't write stuff like that.
No, I say it on your show.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And I don't get paid for it. So, you know, more prestige, less money.
So you've got your 8-year-old nephew. He's 8, right?
He's 8.
And he's what? Does he go to public or private school?
He goes to Catholic school, private school. In fact, did I show you the Catholic school hippo?
Yes, you did. That they got the Catholic
dressed
school.
Dressed up one of my hippos in a Catholic school uniform. How we roll in this house.
So, well, there's a lot of people who have issues with private schools versus public schools. And you know, whatever your concerns may be, I'm pretty sure this one definitely actually goes in the one score point for private school category. Wow. Aldine ISD teacher charged after giving student a lap dance in front of entire class. Criminal charges have been filed against an Aldine middle school teacher for having an inappropriate relationship with a student. Alicia Smith, 42, a teacher at the Stovall Middle School, has been charged with improper relationship, according to court documents. Inappropriate relationship involves giving the student almost a 4-minute long lap dance in front of the whole class that was recorded on video. Where do we begin here?
The rubble or our sins.
And no, you guys in the... What was that?
Stop attacking the heater. It's noisy and we need that for heat.
So, you... There are lots and lots... Got people in the channel are going, oh, where was that teacher when I was a kid? No! That's
called statutory.
Yeah. There's, you know what, you'd be like, well, I was wanting to have sex with teacher when I was at... No, that's not cool. There are lines. There's a reason for those lines, and this is part of it. You don't do this. You don't.
And if you're going, not that you should.
Not that you should.
But if you're going God, no. to nail your students, maybe don't advertise it with a public lap dance in front of the rest of the class.
It was for his birthday, you see. It was a birthday lap dance, so of course no one would have a problem with your teacher giving you a birthday lap dance.
I can't think of a single teacher I would have wanted a birthday lap dance.
Male or female. Yeah, I can't think of one either. I don't think, no. I'm thinking back.
Maybe just have the class sing. Next
yeah,
time.
You know, he's just a rousing rendition of Happy Birthday. Not. You gotta wonder, did she put up the boombox on the desk and start the whole.
And here's the thing. At that age, as I understand it, I've never been a teenage boy. I've never been the owner of a dick.
No.
Except for that one summer in Amsterdam. But. At that age, boys already have problems with, as I understand it, involuntary activity.
Oh yeah, it wants to see the world, whether you want it to or not.
Lap dance in the middle of class, kind of probably ruin the rest of that kid's day. Let's be honest, like.
Yeah.
Let's hope he had a really big binder to carry out of class with him.
Was this just, did she just like at that point, this is like, I don't want this job anymore.
Fuck this job.
How did she possibly think this was going to be okay?
Tell us more about Amsterdam. No. Those records are sealed.
I mean, how did she think, all right, well, I just gave my student a lap dance for the whole class on video. I should think about my lesson plan for tomorrow.
Yeah. Because, you know, I didn't have time to administer that pop quiz because I was giving a lap dance. So we're going to have to push that. And then, you know, the oral presentations are next week. So we're going to have to block out a lot of time for that.
Just imagine. Can you imagine the principal at that point? She did what?
What do you even do when you're that principal? Like, what do you even fucking do? And
drink heavily.
I feel like there was probably a red flag or two that led up to this. This isn't the kind of thing that just spontaneously happens out of nowhere. Like, there's going to be some motherfucking signs.
Yeah.
Before you have a teacher giving kids lap dance.
It's just not suddenly one day, all of a sudden, you know, the tearaway pants and
spontaneous statutory lap dances. Very rare.
Very rare. That's not something.
There's probably some buildup.
Let's move right along, because this is creeping me out. So I don't do stories where kids get hurt. I don't like that. It's not funny. But this, I will do this one because the kid didn't get hurt. Actually, I think he kind of inflicted a little bit of harm in his own way. Kidnapper releases 10-year-old who won't stop singing gospel song.
Oh.
That is a unique defense against that sort of thing. A gospel song saved a 10-year-old Atlanta boy from his kidnapper. Get on the screen there. Stay on the screen. Good. Willie Merrick said he was in his front yard and bent down to pick up some money when someone grabbed him and threw him in a car. He told me he didn't want to hear a word from me. That's when Merrick began to sing a gospel song called Every Praise. The kidnapper started cursing and reportedly told Merrick to shut up, but he wouldn't. He sang the song for about 3 hours until the kidnapper just let him out of the car.
That's impressive.
No, okay, I'm not laughing because this could have gotten fucked up in a bad way. I'm not laughing at that.
This kid got kind of lucky that he had the kind of kidnapper that just dumped him instead of beat him senseless, because that could happen.
I'm just loving the fact that
he compelled him with the power of Christ.
Or
they made two former popes saints this week. This kid should be up, because that shit's a miracle.
Or perhaps he couldn't stay on key to save his fucking life.
At least it wasn't Let It Go. I will tell you, my nephew was standing on my bed last week. He had his little iPod playing Let It Go, and he was rocking the fuck out. And it was pretty adorable.
If you're a kidnapper, if you are intending to kidnap someone, I don't think the whole idea of my give up is a good, you know, it's like, okay, kid, you win. I'm tired of the song. That doesn't seem like a very successful, because, you know, a kid's probably going to go back home and say, hey, mom, dad, guess what the fuck happened to me?
You would hope.
Yeah.
You give a description and license plate numbers and things of that nature.
Yeah, 10-year-olds are smart.
Like a pretty savvy kid.
If it was Rebecca's Black's Friday and that dude would have dropped the kid in less than a minute. Okay, next time, you know what? If you're in the situation again, the much faster way to get out is, it's Friday, got you down, Friday. You'll be out of there.
Or learn that Avril Lavigne song.
Oh, God. Hello, Kitty. No, no, no.
In case you guys were wondering, I put Mike in timeout for that.
That was a war crime. That song is a war crime. Like I said earlier, we
dropped the Geneva Conventions for that sort of thing.
Like I said earlier, I mean, we dropped two nuclear bombs.
Canada just declared war on us.
As I said, we dropped two nuclear bombs on Japan. Haven't we done enough?
Your tail is in
my tail. So, speaking of war crimes, I love when I have a good segue.
That's not a good segue.
You're familiar with the Xbox Call of Duty and Halo and those kind of fucking games, right?
Yes.
Yeah. That otherwise known as your mom, you suck, you motherfucker, dick, cock. You, that's not a bug. That's a feature of the game.
Mm-hmm.
In case you are in the small part of the world who is not familiar with these games.
I'm sorry, I have to pause you for a second because someone pointed this out. We don't generally bash requests. We're bashing Mike's requests.
Yes.
Because Mike goes out of his way to request the worst shit ever. Yes. He takes pride in this.
And he's the producer.
I would not publicly bash one of your requests. Mike is a species unto himself. Someone brought that up in the chat and I just wanted to clarify.
So if you're in the tiny little shred of the world who does not understand Call of Duty and Modern Warfare and all these video games, what you do is you pretend like you're in a war that either ended 40, 50 years ago or hasn't happened yet. You run around and you shoot each other over and over again and you try to see which one of you can come up with the filthiest fucking thing to come out of your mouth.
Yeah.
That is the game. In essence, that's the whole point of these games. There are winners and there are losers. But normally you're playing across the internet and you lose. Well, you lose. That's pretty much it. Except in this case, one kid decided he wasn't going to take the losing lying down. And rather than just call his opponent a motherfucker or something even less appropriate, SWAT team storms home of online gamer following angry rivals hoax call after Call of Duty defeat. Armed police and a SWAT team stormed the home of a petrified online gamer after his rival became incensed over losing a computer game Call of Duty. Vengeful internet geek called 911 posing as the winner, saying he had killed his mother and brother, sending emergency services rushing to the scene. However, when they arrived at the home in Long Island, New York, real close to you, 2-hour standoff ensued before they eventually found Rafael Castillo still playing the video war game in his bedroom. 17-year-old's rival posts as the teenager over Skype telling police.
Here's my question. 2-hour standoff. Did they just sit outside hoping you would come out?
Like, I guess.
If he was playing a video game, totally oblivious, were they just hanging out outside, yelling at the house? Because that's a little embarrassing.
Yeah. But I love the fact that this kid, the 17-year-old rival, posted the teenager over Skype, telling police, "I just killed my mother and I might shoot more people." Okay, if you are going to find one of the least secure methods to cause any sort of, to fake your identity.
Yeah.
Whether you're like calling in a pizza for Icy Wiener or what. Skype is not the best way.
No, you're probably going to get caught.
Very quickly. Because this is the internet.
I didn't know you could call 911 over Skype.
Yeah, you can. You can call landlines over Skype. I think at least yeah.
Can you video chat with 911?
Well, that just gets fucked up.
Well, no, that could be handy because if you can't describe your attacker, you can show them to them while you're getting bludgeoned. Like they could get screen caps. That could be really helpful.
Oh, okay, this is even better. Authorities had flown helicopters over the home before armed officers, including elite members of Nassau County's Special Operations Unit, stormed the address. At one point, they even tried to call the teenager on his mobile phone, but Rafael couldn't hear it ringing as he had his headphones on while playing the game. Police dispatched more than 70 personnel, including paramedics, to the scene. If they found Rafael using virtual firearm to play the game, his mother Maria was in the kitchen making coffee. Brother Jose just returned home from lunch.
So how did they end up outside in a standoff for 2 hours?
I don't know.
Did it not occur to them to knock on the door and ask his mom and take note that she wasn't dead, thank God, and then say, "Hey, has your son shot anybody in the last half hour? Why no? No, he hasn't."
Well, Maria Castillo, 54, said she could only watch helplessly if police raided her home. He told me, "Go out, go out." I said, "What happened?" They said, "Somebody got killed somebody in your house." told the police, my kid's home, my kid's at the computer, he don't know what happened.
How did they, I really want to know how it wound up in a 2-hour standoff. When people were home making coffee.
Yeah, I know. You know, you think they noticed
a SWAT team surrounding her house? Wouldn't that make you
70 people? That's a lot of fucking, that's a lot of fucking people just surrounding your house with the flashing blue lights.
Wouldn't you maybe poke your head out and be like, guys, is everything okay?
Should I be worried?
Help you in some way? Mr. SWAT team leader? I mean, if a SWAT team surrounded the place where I was, I would be pretty concerned by that. And I would probably address that in some way.
Now, I'm not upset with the police for taking this shit seriously, because sadly enough, this shit does happen.
They had no way of knowing it wasn't true. Like, they're not to blame.
Yeah, they erred on the side of caution, and that's a good thing.
Yeah.
But how did this kid ever think this? He was going to get away with this shit?
Well, supposedly they haven't found him yet, they're saying?
Oh, no, well, they haven't released his name.
Okay.
They're hunting him. They investigators believe they found by tracing the schoolboy's IP address. They gonna find you.
They gonna find you. You are so dumb. You are really dumb.
Yeah, how did he think, you know what? This is the perfect crime because I'm using Skype.
Well, how old was he?
17.
Okay, that's old enough to know better.
It's old enough to know better. That's if you're 17 and you're on the internet, you don't understand they can find your ass with Skype.
Yeah.
You're an idiot.
Oh, D.A. Scott Jr.
What?
Bad kid, no teacher laughing.
I shouldn't laugh. Why am I laughing at that? I shouldn't laugh at that. Yeah, I'm going to wait for the follow-up to this when they find the fucking kid. And because you don't do this to the cops, because they're going to be a little cranky when they find your ass.
I need to call SWAT to calm my cat down. Hi. She's a very sweet kitty. She's just boisterous.
So, kids being stupid, we got another one on this one. Oh, God. We have talked on this show many times about the bizarre lengths that kids seem to go to in order to get high in some way, shape, or form. And they are just the stupidest fucking things they will do.
Yeah.
Well, they found another one.
Of course they did.
Of course they did. Kids are now applying lip balm to their eyelids to get high, and it's called Beezin. The new cool way to get high is called Beezin. It's after putting Burt's Bees lip balm wax on the eyelids. Kids say the sensation causes disorientation similar to being drunk or stoned, and even strengthens their attention spans. Dr. Brett Cowan told the Oklahoma City news station it's probably just the feeling of lip balm's ingredients on the eye makes the kids laugh. Peppermint oil is causing the burning sensation. I suppose some of them think that is kind of funny. It's almost as funny as giving yourself pink eye to amuse your friends. Peppermint oil in the lip balm is very strong irritant and cause inflammation in the eye, redness, and eye swelling. Apparently been around since 2013. It seems to be more of a Pop Rocks and Coke thing rather than an addictive habit.
I don't get this.
I don't get it either.
Oh, supposedly it's a hoax. I need that. Thank you.
It's a hoax. Oh, we got hoaxed. Who sent this one in?
I need that.
Who sent this one in? We got hoaxed. Oh, dear.
No, I need that. This is back.
Wow, this one goes a long way around. This one was updated today, too.
Yeah.
Let's see, you've got a local news story.
We've been told it's a hoax, guys. Like, it's a hoax, it's a hoax. Did you know it's a hoax? Oh my God, did you guys know it's a hoax?
Oh, the choir. Seriously, pedantic. Aren't you adorable?
I need that. No, you can't have it. No.
Well, I suppose, you know, the good thing is that's a relief.
No. Well, yes, that is. a relief.
That is a relief.
The bomb is safe.
Well, that gives me a chance to go with my backup story then. I always do keep a little bit of a backup. Good!
Beanie is my god.
Good. So...
now you're all tangled up in it. I don't know how you did that.
So we have...
now I can't put you down.
So we still have a whole bunch of nuclear missiles in this country. Yes. We have a whole wonderful nuclear arsenal. And however, being that we don't seem to give a fuck about infrastructure anymore, well, this story showed up on 60 Minutes, and it's kind of disturbing the fuck out of me. Yeah, Tara's look on her face. 60 Minutes shocked to find 8-inch floppies drive nuclear deterrents.
That's not good.
Now, you're going to love the reasoning on this one. They're saying... a few years ago, we did a complete analysis of our entire network, Major General Jack Weinstein said. Cyber engineers found out the system is extremely safe and extremely secure in the way it's developed. Yes, because nothing can fucking interface with it because it's an antique. It's literally an antique. It's floppy drives, floppy, 8-inch floppies. That's 40 years old, at least. That's an and goddamn teak.
It's like a record.
Yes. Now, here's another thing about floppy disks, that there's a reason we don't use them anymore. And a reason that if you have an old box of floppies one day and you just, for nostalgia's sake, you decide to take one out and play it, and it doesn't work. That's because floppies stop working over time.
They just die.
They lose magnetic cohesion and they go... pfft.
They just die. Cat fur in my mouth.
Now, you know, there is a very simple way to do... they're worried about security. They're worried about nuclear security. They're worried about nuclear security in their system and they don't want... there's a very simple way to build a system... that is completely safe. You know how you do it? You don't! You put in a computer, you don't connect the fucker to the internet, and you're done!
You don't connect it to anything!
No! These guys are taking the Battlestar Galactica school of thought on this one. No, it's perfectly safe, because it's antique and no one can access it.
Most of the young officers stationed at the Launch Control Center had never seen a floppy disk before. Yeah, because if you're 18, maybe you had a zip drive.
Well, we're safe from Cylons, at least. Now, I love how they say, oh, no, it's perfectly... have they tried to test it?
Yeah, it's secure because there's no information on those fuckers anymore.
Right now, Vladimir Putin is going, 8-inch floppies, you say?
Wow.
Computer Ronin, don't worry, floppies are analog. Oh, a little Pacific Rim dig there.
I didn't even know they still made those.
You know, probably they're having, and this, okay. The Hubble runs on a 46 processor, which is a very old processor. And when they were going to say they were going to decommission it, it was because the computer broke, and they're like, we can't build a new one because it's too old. The only reason it's still up there is because they happened to find a backup. What this means is either they have a box of floppies and they're slowly working their way through them.
No, I need those.
Or... the government at great expense has contracted a specific company to continue to make 8-inch floppy drives, probably at great expense.
No, you can't have them.
And you know what they could do with the money they were spending on 8-inch floppy drives? They could update the fucking system!
Yeah, for what they're probably paying for those disks at this point, they could, you know... upgrade so they don't have to call in Matthew Broderick when the war game starts.
Yeah, the fucking Whopper and shit.
Would you like to play a game?
I'm going to say it right now. They're over in Russia going.
Yeah, because in Russia, they've got zip drives.
So they're a little more advanced. A little bit more advanced. It's
like, this can hold 100 of those. We are ready.
Okay, M. Cipher, it is the Cold War. You are likely to be eaten by a Gru. If you get that one, I love you. That is a wonderful old... So our last story this week. I feel bad because we haven't had a comparable story for the men in a while. But I think you know which story this is. You probably got sent this one as well. Ladies...
I don't always look at the ones people send me because I like to be surprised. I like my reactions to be genuine.
Ladies, those of you watching at home, I would like to inform this: you take the following appropriate action for this next story. I hardly recommend it. Okay, so. You know, I don't have a segue of this one. We just got to jump into this. Oh, God, that's a bad... We just got to jump into the... No, I shouldn't. That's a bad phrasing. That's a very bad phrasing.
I don't like where this is going.
I don't like... You're not going to like where this is going.
Can I have Bridget handle this one?
Teen had loaded revolver in her vagina.
I did see this one. Did we not cover this last week?
No. No.
Nope. Am I just getting deja vu?
Nope. We did not have the loaded vagina last week.
Oh, I tweeted this.
19-year-old Tennessee woman had a loaded handgun hidden in her vagina when she was brought to jail yesterday afternoon following a collar for driving with a suspended license. As Dallas Archer was being booked into the Kingsport jail, a female correctional officer alerted to an unknown object in the teenager's crotch during a search. Jail and a female cop then accompanied Archer to a bathroom for further examination. It led to the recovery of a North American Arms 22LR revolver loaded, which Dallas had concealed in her vagina. Subsequent check revealed the 5-shot mini revolver, which is 4 inches in length, had been stolen from an auto burglary in 2013. That handgun, which police value at $250, is owned by John Souther, a 70-year-old retired car salesman. I don't think he wants it back.
Well, no, I think I seem to remember him saying, like, he might need to have it cleaned. Oh, but added the weapon would require... He noted that he would eventually like the little fellow return, but added that the weapon would require a bath and bleach.
He actually calls it the little fellow. You know, that's normally...
Maybe he does, too. Bang, bang.
Of all the things.
You gotta wonder which way it was facing.
Of all the things we have seen people put.
Because facing one way, horrible idea. Everything wrong with it. Nothing okay. Facing the other way, if you're really working on your Kegels, you're the deadliest woman in the world.
Of all.
Who's gonna see that coming? Nobody. Nobody expects to actually get shot by a vagina.
Oh, my God.
You know?
Of all the things to put in there.
Yeah.
I would not, because this is a thing that... This will put holes in you! And all joking aside, it doesn't matter which direction it's facing, it's taking some flesh with it wherever it goes.
Samantha Brown, you have to get out of here. Your vagina is loaded.
The bacon dragon. You can see the lifted skirt on the grassy knoll. You have to go back and check the Zabruder film for that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jackie O actually did it. Who knew? Or maybe it was Marilyn. She's really famous for that thing where her skirt blows up.
I just, my God. Keep in mind, she was in there for a suspended license.
Yeah. Talk about compounding your error.
And what, did she really think they weren't gonna find it? When she goes through the metal detector?
And they, I mean, why? I have so many questions.
So many. Oh, no, please ask.
Like, why did you have the stolen gun in the first place? Why did you decide that was where you should hide it? Why did you think they wouldn't find it? What was your plan? What was your plan?
A whole new meaning to finger bang.
Ooh. Mm. I don't know about that one.
When they said Janie had a gun, I didn't realize it was there.
Oh.
It's a gun! It's a fucking gun!
At least unload it before you jam it up.
And Computer Ronin says, there's a Hot Fuzz joke in there somewhere.
Like, at least don't shove it up there loaded, for God's sake.
I know, you had the chance to just dump the bullets.
Right. Like, a 22 only holds, like, two bullets, right?
No, this was a five-bullet revolver.
Okay, well, you could have gotten, like, dumped the bullets, and if you must jam a gun up your vagina, I don't know a situation where you'd have no other choice, but if you must, if you're in some kind of Robert Rodriguez Quentin Tarantino movie, and you must do this, unload it first.
Annie, get your gun out of there! Oh, lovely.
You'll shoot your vagina out. We can just kind of relax. They're doing our job for us here.
I know. It's the, they're having just a...
I can play with the cat, who's now gone to sleep. Because I won't give her my headphones to eat. She's mad at me.
You know, she was just walking through there, going very carefully not to jostle herself.
How do you walk like that?
I don't know. I don't want to know.
Like, as the owner of a vagina, I'm here to tell you, I don't think you can really comfortably walk with a gun jammed up there. First of all, it's not shaped right.
No, and it's got pointy bits.
The guns are shaped like this.
It's got pointy bits and moving bits and pinchy bits and...
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah, I know! Why do you think I did the I brace yourselves.
Like the safety. Oh my God. I mean, maybe she's into that sort of thing. We're not here to judge people's life choices.
I just love the look on her face. Is like, yep.
Yeah, and she is rocking that top knot.
Like, well, here I am. Of all the things to be famous for, you know, you think. You're going to become a sports, you know, star or a rock star or cure cancer, but nope. Whenever anyone searches for Dallas Archer on the internet.
I feel like she was never under the impression she was going to cure cancer.
Oh, God. So what have we learned this week? It is not a pocket, a purse, and most definitely, it's not a fucking holster.
It is not a bag of holding. It's not for storage. It's not for storage of anything.
You know, I mean, ladies and gentlemen, you come into this world with a set number of holes. Try not to leave with more than that.
Well, I mean, I have my ears pierced. That's two extra holes. Like, you know. Within reason.
Within reason. We learned this week that potatoes have many uses. A firearm is not one of them.
No.
No.
And don't put that up your vagina either. I feel like that's a natural progression. Like next week, we're going to get the chick who got an infection because she was storing potatoes up her vagina.
Oh my God.
Because that's what we do.
We've learned lap dance is not for the classroom.
No. Unless you're teaching a class on giving a lap dance.
Yeah. Otherwise,
that's probably not going to be taught to 14-year-old boys.
Yeah, when your lesson plan for the day includes statutory.
No, it's a bad lesson plan and you should start over.
Yeah. You should. No.
Just don't do that. Don't do that.
We've learned that if kidnapped, go with the song that never ends. You could potentially get yourself out of the situation.
Or murdered.
But
that kid compelled his kidnapper with the power of Christ, so good for him.
Or just being really off key. I don't know. One or the other. Either way. That kidnapper gave up way too easy. Jeez, yeah, his heart just wasn't in that shit.
Have you ever been in a car with a small child for hours?
Point.
Like, I love my nieces and nephews. I love them. They're made of magic and rainbows and unicorn dust.
But you like to be able to get the fuck away from them.
There's a reason I'm not a mom. Mm. I'm like, being with a small child in a car for hours, they wouldn't do that to people at Gitmo.
We've learned that when you lose at an online game, good sportsmanship is encouraged. Calling a fucking airstrike in the really real world is not.
Two little words, proportionate response. Yeah. I got in a fight today with the guy at the pizza place where I go to lunch every day. He's very, very angry at me because I said the Dark Knight Rises sucked.
It did.
I know. He loved it. He saw it 4 times in the theater.
Who builds a nuclear reactor with a fucking countdown clock on it?
He spends a lot of time around pizza ovens, you know. He thought Captain America 2 sucked. We disagree on this. He's clearly Hydra, but whatever. And he told me that his brother told him that The Dark Knight Rises sucked after they went to see it. So he stopped at a gas station, asked his brother to go in and get him a drink, and left him there and made him walk 4 miles home. And I'm like, that's not a proportionate response.
No.
Like, did he do horrible things to you when you were kids? He's like, no, we get along great. And I'm like, then that's not a proportionate response.
You've got issues.
It's just not. Does the punishment fit the crime?
Yeah, does beating you at a video game warrant the SWAT team?
No.
Because, you know, once they're figured out what's going on, they're going to come and find you and they're going to be grumpy and they have assault weapons.
And warrants.
And battering rams.
And your permanent record.
And finally,
when they say this will go on your permanent record, that's what they mean.
Yeah. Finally, this week, we learned that in the case of a nuclear war, we are fucked!
8-inch floppies.
8-inch floppy drive. All because someone was a cheap motherfucker is what it came down to.
I mean, you hear 8-inch floppy these days and you assume someone's talking about porn.